Okay, so for this afternoon, we will discuss, di ba, under ACC 1 to 3, Financial Accounting and Reporting Subject with reference. So I'm using the Book of Intermediate Accounting 1, Volume 1, 2020 by Conrado Valix, Jose Peralta, and Christian Aris M. Valix. So for this afternoon, we will discuss two chapters, cash and cash equivalents, and bank reconciliation. Let's start with cash and cash equivalents. Sa idea ninyo, cash and cash equivalents. So basically, cash and cash equivalents, this is the first line item. In your statement of financial position. Diba? First line item in your statement of financial position. Okay, so money ang pinakaunang item sa inyong financial position, di ba? Cash and cash equivalents. So kanang cash and cash equivalents, wala na siya ang whole account nga gigamit, line item nga gigamit, pero unsay sulod ana nila? Di ba? Like unsay mga transactions ana nila? Aha na gikan ilang transactions. Okay, aha na gikan ang ilang transactions. Okay, so this afternoon, we will discuss, diba, specific items, transactions affecting cash and cash equivalents. Okay, so we'll start with, diba, first line item, mapuni pinakauna sa imong assets under current asset. Okay, cash, diba, what you mean by cash? Diba, in layman's term, bring kag cash, money, kwarta. Money itong ginabayad pag mupalita, ginagamit pag mupalita, di ba? Sa atong everyday transactions. If we purchase it something, manghulam ta, money atong inadawat, cash, kwarta. So basically, pag mayintag cash, in layman's term, money. Medium of exchange, di ba? So, but in accounting parlance, kung mayintag cash, dili lang money, dili lang iyong ta kwarta, kanang sinsilyo, kanang bills, dili lang pasabot ana cash. So, in accounting parlance, cash includes money and other negotiable instrument that is payable in money and acceptable by the bank for deposit and immediate credit. So when you say cash, di lang sa money, but other negotiable instrument that is payable in money and acceptable by the bank for deposit and immediate credit. So basically, kung may kag cash, money ang composition sa imong cash. Cash, pwede cash on hand, di ba? Cash on hand, cash nga nasa imong mga kamot. Pwede cash in bank, cash nga nasa bangko. Or, cash fund set aside for current purpose. Okay, so again, pumingkag cash, that's cash on hand, cash in bank. When you say cash on hand, unsay composition ng cash on hand? Di ba? Unsay nasa cash on hand? Okay, so cash on hand, example under cash on hand, undeposited cash collections and other cash items awaiting for deposit. Siyempre, napa sa imo, wala pa na deposit sa bangko. Di ba? Because napa sa imo, awaiting for deposit. Okay, customer's check. Cheque, gikan kang customer. Okay, kita ang business. Di ba? Kita ang business, si customer, ang gibayad sa to, cheque. So therefore, pag may kag check, kung naakay cheque, pasabot ang cheque is considered as cash. Muna yun dira, negotiable instrument because cheque is a negotiable instrument. So again ha, ang cheque, papel rin na siya, pero that is considered as cash. Like for example, kung akong gibayad sa imo cheque or ang gibayad ni customer check, automatic imong entry, nagdawat ka og cash. Diba cash imong i-record, cash imong i-record. Pag cheque ang gibayad sa imo or cheque imong gibayad. Okay. Although papel ra na siya, di ba? But that is already considered as cash. Cashier's or manager check, as long as it's a check, di ba? Cashier or manager's check. You have traveler's checks, bank drafts, money orders. Okay. Dili po kayo ko familiar with these terms, but these are part of your cash on hand. So, the money orders, bank drafts, traveler's check, cashier's or manager's check. Second item is cash in bank. Diba? Cash nga naa sa bangko. Because if you're a business owner, dili man pwede nga imong cash nara sa imo, itago ra nimo sa imong vault, itago ra nimo sa imong tindahan, di ba? Manotice ninyo mga dagkong a company nag-aadto gyud bangko naga-deposit, or even they let the bank mga tellers moadto sa company, di ba? Kanang mga teller nga kanang mag-trap moadto sa tindahan, mag-count, mag-ihap sa kwarta, tapos mag-armor card. So, di ba? Moadto pa gani sa company para lang magkuha ang kwarta, ma-deposit sa bangko. Okay. So, unsay naa sa cash in bank? So, pwede na kay demand deposit or checking account. You say demand deposit or checking account, katong kanang makaiso kag cheque. Makabantay mo kung for some of you kanang nay ATM, di ba? Kung nay ATM, tapos pag mag-withdraw mo or let's say mag-withdraw mo or mag-balance inquiry, di ba, mangunta na ang machine nga unsa nga account, savings account ba or checking account. So, unsay kalahian ana nila? Kung may kag savings account, dili ka pwede mo isu og check ana. Mora na siya. Gi-save lang ni savings account, kumbaga gi-deposit lang nimo sa bangko ang imong kwarta para i-save nimo digto for protection purposes pod na para na lang sa bangko. Tapos pwede sa mo earn og interest ginagmay. Pero pag demand deposit or checking account, normally dili sa mo earn og interest. So mura na kalayaan niya. So yung say demand deposit or checking account, money nga account nga digto pwede ka maka-issue og cheque. Diba? So sulatan lang nimo o bayad na ko money. So katong cheque, diri ka on nga account sa imong checking account. Okay. So under cash in bank, pwede po ka na i-saving deposit. Take note that your saving deposit should be considered as unrestricted as to withdrawal to be part of your cash. Again, nalik yung savings, pero dapat unrestricted sa anytime you can withdraw. Pwede nimo makuha ang imong kwarta. Okay, that's cash in bank. Okay, mo na sulod sa imong cash in bank. Next, cash fund set aside for current purpose. So this is also part of your cash. Like for example, na kay small petty cash fund. Di ba, nagbilin ka, aside sa cash on hand, nagbilin ka og like specific amount na 5,000 para ni sa petty cash. So kato siya, those are cash funds set aside for current purpose. Diba? Para in case na ay mga ginagmay nga paliton, dinalian nga pagpalit, pwede ni mo kaon sa petty cash fund. Pwede po sa payroll fund, because set aside for payroll. Fund set aside for payroll. Kaninga fund, para lang gini sa payroll sa company. Dividend fund. Okay, this fund, para ni sa mga dividends. Like for example, mga cooperatives, diba? They issue dividends. Okay, mga corporation, diba? They issue dividends. Travel fund, o kani, nag-set aside kag fund for travels. Like, for example, sa company, kay na yung mga seminars, trainings, ang mga employees, so, nagin na naka-budget, naka-set aside na. Pero, karon medyo dili kayo siguro ni uso ang travel fund because bawal pa ang travel-travel. Tax fund, yung set aside fund, cash, for tax purposes. Pangbayad din nyo sa yung monthly nga payment sa monthly payable sa BIR or quarterly or annual payable niyo sa BIR. Interest fund. You set aside this fund pangbayad sa interest monthly. So, dapat current purpose siya, 'di ba? When say current purpose, short term ang purpose niya. To be part of your cash. So again, ang cash na to dili lang kwarta. Pwede cash on hand, cash in bank, then cash fund set aside for current purpose. Okay, there's no specific standards dealing with cash. Actually, walay standard nga nag-ingon na unsaon nimo pag-record ang cash, how to account the cash. Actually, walay standard na nag-ingon dealing with cash. The only guidance is found in PAS 1, di ba, Philippine Accounting Standard or IAS, International Accounting Standard 1, paragraph 66, which provides that an entity shall classify an asset as current when the asset is cash or cash equivalent. Therefore, if the item is considered as cash or cash equivalent, it is classified as classify as an asset under current asset. Yeah, and we know that cash is an asset account. It's a current asset account. unless it is restricted to settle a liability for more than 12 months after the end of the reporting period. So, pasabot ani, kung naa kay cash, girestrict ni mo, di ba, nai-restriction nga kaninga kwarta para ni pangbayad sa utang nga sobra 1 year. Mudyo sobra 1 year. Katunga cash, although cash siya, money siya, pero kay girestrict man ni mo, there's a restriction, dili sa part sa imong cash and cash equivalent account. Dili sa maklasify as current asset. Diba? Dili sa part sa imong cash. Why? Because accordingly, to be reported as cash, an item must be unrestricted in use. Again, to be reported as part of the cash account, an item must be unrestricted in use. Dapat walay restrictions. Anytime pwede gamiton ang cash. Sir, what if naay restriction, sir? Asset gapon siya pero dili sa part sa imong cash. Ah, kumangutan na ko, pilay balance sa cash. Ayaw i-appeal ang naay restrictions. Pilay balance sa asset, pwede sa asset pero dili sa cash. Di ba? Depending on the restrictions. Pwede man sa long term, pwede po sa short term. So dapat to be classified as cash, dapat there's no restrictions. No restrictions. Pwede siya magamit anytime. Okay, this means that the cash must be readily available in payment of current obligations and not to be subject any restrictions, contractual or otherwise. So again, items to be classified as cash should be unrestricted. Kaya lang yung timay na, dapat unrestricted. Kung naay restriction, dili appeal sa cash. Asset gapon siya, pero dili sa part sa cash. Because our focus now, si cash, o si cash equivalent, unsay mga transactions, sulod ani nila, specific transactions na pwede ma-account under cash equivalents. Okay, I hope clear siya, to be part of the cash, it must be unrestricted. How about cash equivalents? What do you mean by cash equivalence? So according to Past 7, Paragraph 6, a cash equivalence is a short-term, highly liquid investments that are readily convertible into cash and so near their maturity that they present insignificant risk of changes in value because of changes in interest rate. So kung may cash equivalent, that is an investment. Investment na siya. Kung minkag cash equivalent, short-term, highly liquid investment. So, minkag highly liquid, pasabot highly liquid, kanang dali ra kayo nimo sa pwede ma-convert into cash. Diba? Readily convertible into cash. It's an investment, but anytime or highly liquid siya, diba? May say liquid, dali na siya mo sa pwede ma-convert into cash that they present insignificant risk. May say insignificant risk, dili kayo dako ang diferensa, dili kayo dako ang diferensa in terms of interest, di ba, changes on interest rate. Why? Because short term naman gid siya, dili kayo dako ang diferensa interest niya because short term ra sa nga investment, short term ra sa nga investment. So, di ba, cash equivalent, short-term, highly liquid investment, readily convertible into cash, and present insignificant risk of changes in value because of changes in interest rates. But to qualify as cash equivalent, sir, unsa ang definition na short-term? Di ba, unsa definition na short-term, sir? To qualify as cash equivalents, it must be highly liquid investment that are, take note, that are acquired 3 months before maturity. Diba? So, makonsider sa as cash equivalents if imong gipalit acquire, gipalit ang investment 3 months before maturity. Ang importante dire, gipalit, gi-acquire 3 months before sa mudzu, before its maturity. These are example of cash equivalents. 3-month treasury bill, or this is a 3-month, pasabot, 3 months yung magipalit, this is considered as cash equivalent. 3-year, sir, year ba na ginawa, sir? Tulo ka tuig na treasury bill, pero purchase 3 months before date of maturity. Diba? 3 years ang period, maturity period sa treasury bill, pero gipalit ni mo siya, gi-acquire ni mo siya 3 months before its maturity date because the requirement is only acquired 3 months before maturity. So, bahala pag 1 year, 5 years na siya, as long as you purchase that treasury bill, you purchase that investment, highly liquid investment, 3 months before the date of maturity. Okay, that's the important there, di ba? Purchase 3 months before date of maturity. Next, 3 month time deposit. Okay, 3 months time deposit. Di ba, familiar mo sa time deposit? The concept of time deposit is, let's say, patulugon ni mo ang kwarta, di ba? Time. Gideposit ni mo with a specific time. Di ba? So, normally, dako ni sa interest because patulugon man ni mo ang kwarta for a specific period of time. But you cannot withdraw the money if wala pa niabot to nga time. Okay. Okay, so that's time deposit. So, time deposit, 3 month time deposit. Lang, 3 months na po ang mo-qualify. And this time deposit is evidenced by certificate of deposit. Because na yung mga problems, diba, as per observation with the problems, some of the problems, dili sila mo state dito ang time deposit. Because you need to identify pila ang cash equivalent. So, na yung mga problems, na dili sila mo yung time deposit, ilang ihatag sa inyo certificate of deposit. If makakita mo ang certificate of deposit, that refers to time deposit. Okay, again, that refers to time deposit. Sir, what if sa problem, sir, silent? Wala gibutang 3 months. Wala gipakita, sir, sa problem nga. Gipalit sa 3 months before maturity date. If the problem is silent, the assumption is that item is considered cash equivalent. Again, if the problem is silent, that item is considered as cash equivalent. Kung gibutang ra, time deposit, unsa man na siya? Cash equivalent, or other asset. Pag inana lang gibutang, that's considered as cash equivalent. Okay, that's the assumption. Okay, last is 3 month money market instrument or commercial paper. If makita mo money market instrument or commercial paper, then that is considered as cash equivalents. Dapat 3 months lang. 3 months lang iyang qualification. Pero again, if the problem is silent, if the problem is silent, the assumption is cash equivalent siya. Okay, that is cash equivalent. Okay, sa hipod, part of the control, part of the cash management, diba, if natay excess nga kwarta sa business, ang idea, dili nato siya, i-save lang sa bank. Diba, idea is dili yan sa i-save sa bank. Kaya sayang, diba, when we know, gamay ragid ang interest rate sa banks. What if you will invest that excess amount na dili nimo ginagamit sa operation nimo? Pwede nimo sa invest into time deposits, money market instruments, treasury bills. Why? Because these are investment account. Diba? These are investment account nga that will give you higher interest income. Okay, so if you have part of the cash management, if na lang kay excess, diba nga, sobra, medyo nindot ang kita karon, exceed man, kaya pa man nato bayaran ang mga current expenses, dapat ay sobra, what if, let's invest this amount. Diba? Invest nato sa time deposit, invest nato sa money market, invest nato sa treasury bill, because these investments will give you higher return compared sa bank. Diba? Compared sa bank. So, napugay pagpilian ni mo kung pila ka term imong gusto, diba, to invest the excess cash. So, if the term is 3 or less, such instruments are classified as cash equivalents. Diba? Because cash equivalents, if you acquire investment 3 months before its maturity date, kanisi yung first, short term, tapos 3 or less, such instrument are classified as cash equivalents. Therefore, included in the caption cash and cash equivalent. If the term is more than 3 months, sobra 3 months, but within 1 year, di na sa cash equivalents, di ba? Because nilapas na sa 3 months. Pero within 1 year, still current. Current gapon because within a year. Such investments are classified as short-term investment and presented separately as current asset. So pag more than 1 year, within 1 year, more than 3 months, the investment is considered as short-term investment. So lay pud sa nga account presented separately as current asset. Dili ka magamit og kani nga account cash and cash equivalent. Pero if the term is more than 1 year, the invest ka more than 1 year mong invest on such investment is classified as non-current or long-term investment. However, if such investments become due within 1 year from the end of the reporting period, they are reclassified current or temporary investments. Okay, so pwede ka mo invest if you have the excess cash. Diba? As part of the cash management of the company. Kaya sayang kung i-save lang sa banko. What if mangita kag other instrument that will give you higher interest income? Measurement. How are we going to measure cash? Okay, if I entry sa financial statement, sorry, short-term investment, that will be the entry. Yes, pwede na. Pwede na imong entry ato short-term investment, let's say cash, nagpalit ka, oh, let's say 1 million. Pwede na siya. Pwede na siya sa imong entry. Under current asset siya. Okay. Measurement. How are we going to measure your cash account? So, cash is measured at face value, of course, diba? At face value, kung unsay makita nimo, dili pwede nga nakay 20 pesos nga bill, 30 imong i-record. O, diba? So, at face value, nakay 5 nga sinsilyo, 20 imong i-record. So, dili, say na na. So, cash is measured at face value. Kung unsay naa sa bill, unsay naa sa coin, motuwa i-record nimo. Okay. But what if there's cash in foreign currency? Like, for example, ikaw business, nakay transactions abroad. Ang ginabayad sa imo dili Philippine peso, at the same time imong ginabayad dili pod Philippine peso. So saan na to sa pag-measure? So we measure the cash in foreign currency at current exchange rate. Like for example, kung karon ang transaction na itabo gibayaran ka pilay exchange rate ana karon. Let's say 50 pesos, dollar, $1. $1 50 pesos. So 50 pesos na siya. Okay, because di ba part of the monetary, diba, atong assumption na dapat panganlan nato siya at Philippine peso because we are in the Philippines. Okay, so measurement, again, measurement. So cash is measured at face value and cash in foreign currency measured at current exchange rate. Okay, how about financial statement presentation? How are we going to present cash account in the financial statement. Alawa, nisa, wala nisa na edit. Okay, so how are we going to present cash account? Okay, in the financial statements. Are we going to present the cash in the statement of financial position? So wala sa na edit. Sorry for this. Okay, so actually, di ba, inko gai na cash is presented as the first line item. Siya ang pinakauna sa imong statement of financial position or sa imong FS under current asset. Okay, so that is how we present cash. Simple naman ang presentation sa cash, dili kaya sa complicated. Okay, cash maintained in a bank undergoing bankruptcy is excluded from cash and presented as receivable measured at realizable value. What if naakay savings kang bank A? Nakay savings dira 50,000. Pero si bank A pa-bankrupt na, palugi na. Unsaon nimo pag-present ning cash nimo kang bank A nga palugi na si bank A. Diba sa inyo sa standard, cash maintained in a bank undergoing bankruptcy or na bankrupt na gyud because undergoing bankruptcy is excluded from cash and presented as receivable measured at realizable value. Therefore, kanang 50,000 dili nimo sa pwede i-appeal kang cash. Why? Because somehow there's a restriction because diba dili pa na makabayad sa imo ang bangko because undergoing bankruptcy siya. So unsa na to ni sa pag-record? We record this one as receivable. Natay receivable kang bank. Okay, natay receivable kang bank. So again ha, kaninga 50,000, this is not recorded as cash, but it is recorded sa atong libro as receivable. Okay, I hope it's clear. Second, deposits in foreign current countries which are not subject to any foreign exchange restriction are included in cash. So if you have deposits sa lahi nga country, like sa US, na kay account dito, na kay deposits, which are not subject to any foreign exchange restriction, so again, unrestricted siya, are included in cash. As long as there's no restrictions, and for current purpose, part sa cash nimo. But if restricted siya, it is presented as receivable subject to allowances and impairment, then disclose the restrictions. Like sa bank A, sa US ni siya nga bank, nakay 50,000 savings dito. Diba? Kung wala restriction, that's part of your cash. If no restriction. But if there is restriction, the 50,000 is under your receivable. It's not recorded under your cash, diba? Presented as receivable subject to allowances and impairment. Then you need to disclose the restrictions. Why there is restriction? Nga nung naay restrictions? Or what are the reasons for the restrictions? Okay, cash fund for a certain purpose. Question so far, basin na mo yung pangutana. Question so far? None. So, let's continue. Cash fund for certain purpose. Okay. Cash fund for certain purpose. So, if the cash fund is for current operations or payment for current obligations, the cash and cash equivalent is under your current asset. Okay. Yung say purpose sa imong cash fund ga set aside. So, purpose ani nga cash? Ang purpose ani, pangbayad sa among current operations. Pangbayad sa among current obligations. Therefore, unsa na to pag-present ang cash nga imong set aside for current operations, for current obligation, that is part of your cash in cash equivalents reported under current asset. But what if ang cash, kaninga cash, set aside na ako ni for non-current purposes, for payment of non-current obligations, unsaon na ako pag-classify aning nga cash if ang akong purpose pangbayad aning non-current, pangbayad aning non-current nga utang, then that cash is classified as long-term investment. Long-term investment under non-current asset. Diba? Giset aside nimo for long-term purposes. Actually, example ani, let's say sinking fund. Diba, we're familiar with sinking fund. So, depende on sa purpose nimo sa sinking fund. If nag-sinking fund mo, kay namoy annual nga laag kada annual na ganit, tuig pa. So, namoy annual nga laag, diba? So, nag-sinking fund mo, 5-5 kada adlaw, kay maglaag mo pag December. So, ang purpose ninyo, short term raman na, because, diba, for laag within the year, every year. So, katong sinking fund ninyo, pwede sa under cash. But if ang sinking fund, normally, if silent ang sinking fund, that's for long-term purposes. You set aside that fund for long-term purposes. Okay. Classification of cash fund. How are you going to classify the cash fund? Classification of cash fund as current or non-current should parallel the classification of the related liability. Si pasabot ana, sir. So, i-classify nato ang cash fund as current or non-current, magdepende kung aha nato sa gigamit. Should be parallel to the classification of the related liability. So, if kaninga fund set aside for current liability, therefore, this cash fund is under your cash, considered as current asset. But if this cash fund is set aside for non-current liabilities, then that fund is considered also as non-current liability. Kumbaga parallel siya. Kung unsay purpose niya, long-term ba, short-term, mapod iyang classification. Okay, that's parallel. However, a cash fund set aside for the acquisition of non-current assets should be classified as non-current regardless of the year of disbursement. Let's say, cash fund set aside for acquisition of non-current asset. Naglahi ko og 1 million kay magpalit ko og L3 para sa business. Di ba? Nag-set aside ko 1 million pang palit og L3. Let's say duha ka L3 para sa business. Di ba non-current asset imong gipalit? Nag-set aside ka og fund. Question karon katong fund nga imong giset aside para pagpalit og L3 part ba to sa imong current asset, part ba to sa imong non-current asset? So unsay classification ato nga fund? The classification is non-current because regardless of the year kanus ani mo paliton, next year baka ugma baka ha, or after 3 months baka siya, because the purpose is you set aside for non-current asset man imong paliton. Therefore, the cash fund is also classified as non-current. Okay, if your purpose is to acquire non-current asset. Question so far. Nasabtan ra ba? Uy, wala mo tingog. Isa lang nakasabot. How about ang uban?
Yes, sir.
Okay, sige. Pila ra may estudyante na ko
diri. Yes, sir,
kasabot. O numra kong estudyante. Ni daghan na mga napulo na. Okay, bantay ha, bantay ang yes sir ha. Sige, padayon ta. Okay, bank overdraft. What do you mean by bank overdraft? Saan ang bank overdraft? So generally, this is not permitted in the Philippines. Diba? This is not permitted in the Philippines, but part gapon sa problem. Okay, bank overdraft. What do you mean by overdraft? When the cash in bank account has a credit balance. Diba? Cash in bank has a normal balance of debit. Diba? Debit yung normal balance. Kung kag bank overdraft, ang imong kwarta sa bangko, nagka-credit balance, pasabot nag-negative. Diba? Mo nang itawag na bank overdraft. Nag-negative ang imong account sa bangko. That's why, ginayon, it's not permitted in the Philippines because kung na-checking nga imong giiso tapos walay sulod ang imong bank account, mo nang gitawag nila nga mutalbog, di ba? Mutalbog ang check dili dawaton sa bangko. That's why dili na siya permitted in the Philippines because dili man na ginapadayon sa bangko. Because kung walay sulod, ilag yun ang ibalik ang check. Okay, so kung kag bank overdraft, again, nag-negative. Nagka-credit balance ka. Instead nga normal balance debit, nagka-negative ka. So yan may tabo, the account ni cash in bank, diba? Naakay deposit nga 100 pero imong giisu 150 na negative kag 50. So manang gitawag nga overdraft. Diba? So nanubrang imong gipang-isu nga cheque kaysa sa sulod sa imong bank account. Okay, so a bank overdraft is classified, how do we account bank overdraft? So bank overdraft is classified as current liability. Okay, bank overdraft is classified as current liability. So therefore, utang nato ni. 'Di ba? Utang nato ni. So utang nato ning bank overdraft. Okay, so current liability and should not be offset against other bank accounts with debit balances. Sir, unsay pasabot ana, sir? Should not be offset against other bank accounts with debit balances. If nakay bank overdraft, that is a liability account, current liability, and dili daw sa i-offset against other bank accounts with debit balances. Okay, sige, let's. Let's have an illustration. Okay, money na nahitabo. Okay, so current liability siya, at the same time, should not be offset against other bank. Kita ang company, company A. If you have noticed, if namoy mga businesses or namoy kailangan na business, dili ra gyud na isa ka bank account ang naila. Dili ra gyud na isa ka bank account ang ila. Ila gyud ang ginabalin-balin sa lahi nga mga accounts. Or let's say, si company A, nasa'y account kang BDO. Nasa'y account kang Metro Bank. Nasa'y account kang Security Bank. Nasa'y account kang, sa pa may mga bank dira.
BPI.
BPI. Sige, BPI. Let's say, money na itabo. Kang BDO, naasay debit balance na paisulod niyang account nga 100. Kagamay no. So, sige lang, 100 for illustration purposes. Kang Metro Bank, naasay sulod na 200. Kang Security Bank, nag-negative 50. Kang BPI, dako-dako iyang kwarta diri na say 500. Unsa man ang business, sir. Sige lang, di ba? Tuhanan na nato KB. Sige. Okay, para dako-dako. Okay. Nabay overdraft. Naa, di ba? Nay overdraft. Kaya si Security Bank, nag-negative 50,000. Nung sa gani classification, aning 50,000? Current liability, di ba? This is a liability. Pasabot kita, company A, natay bayronon kang Security Bank 50 kaya nanubra ang atong gi-iso na cheque or nasubra atong gi-withdraw or unsa ba, gibayad through check. Okay, question karon, should not be offset against other bank account with debit balances. So kanang 50,000 nimo liability gina siya. Dili nimo sa pwede ipakang kang 100, di nimo sa pwede i-offset kang 200, di nimo sa pwede i-offset kang 500. Question karon, pilay balance sa imong cash? Cash in bank. Pilay balance. Okay, the answer is 800,000. So imong cash 800,000 nga naman 100 kang BDO, 200 kang Metro Bank, 500 kang BPI. Again, because this negative 50,000 is a current liability and should not be offset against other bank account with debit balances. Katong mga positive di nimo sa pwede i-minus, di nimo sa pwede i-offset. Okay. So the answer is you have cash balance 800,000 and you have a liability of 50,000. Okay. Clear ba? Clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, I hope no, dili ba sab pwede i-offset sa savings, sir? Dili sa pwede i-offset with different bank because that's according to the standard or according to, oh yes, the standard. But this is the general rule. Diba? This is the general rule. So you see, general rule, sir, naday exemptions. Liability is like utang. Yes, utang. Bali na kay bayronon kang, natay bayronon kang Security Bank na 50,000. What e-entry, sir, sa financial statement? Saniwa, what is the entry, sir, sa financial statement? No, what is the journal entry? Imong pasabot ha, what is the journal entry? Okay, journal entry ana liability siya. Pwede ka magbutang og liability account ani. Okay, to be considered as liability, kung dagan og accounts. Oh, again, let's scan. Continue. General rule, that's the general rule nga pag naay overdraft, that's a current liability. And should not be offset against other bank accounts with debit balances. Okay, since it's a general rule, sir, naaday exemptions. Yes, naay exemptions. Unsay exemption, sir? Na pwede nato ma-offset ang overdraft. Na pwede nato ma-offset ang overdraft. sa other accounts. Okay, so it is the exemption. Exemption to the rule when an entity maintains two or more accounts in one bank. First exemption, so pwede din sa i-offset. First, when an entity maintains two or more in one bank, two or more accounts in one bank, and one's account results in an overdraft while the other account has a debit balance. First scenario, pwede siya i-offset like BDO. Sa BDO, na kay account BDO 1, 50,000. BDO 2, Metro Bank, 50,000. You have BPI, 100,000. Okay, the first exception, when an entity maintains two or more accounts in one bank. In this case, sa BDO, naakay duha ka account. Naakay BDO account 1, BDO account 2. Imong BDO account 1, naay positive 50,000. Imong BDO account 2, nag-negative 30,000. Therefore, this is overdraft, di ba? Overdraft 30,000. Question, pwede ba sa i-offset? The answer is yes. Pwede sa i-offset. Because according to the first rule, exemption, pwede sa i-offset once naakay more than one account sa isa ka bank. Tapos ang isa ka account positive, ang isa ka account negative. Question, pilay balance sa imong cash if this is the problem, if this is the case. Pilay balance sa imong cash. Akong question, how much is the balance of cash? Pila?
170,000, sir.
Okay, the answer is 170,000. Why? Pwede sa ma-offset, di ba? So, ang nabilin sa imong BDO, 20 na lang, plus 50 sa Metro Bank, plus 100 sa BPI, that's 170,000. Okay, pwede sa ma-offset. What's the second exception? If the amount of the overdraft is not material. When you say not material, that's relevance. That is relevant. That is relative. Diba? So, yung kag-relative, depende. Because, depende, yes, dili sa relevant. O, dili sa relevant pag may kag not material. But sir, pila ang amount sa not material? Diba? Wala tay specific threshold about materiality. Because it will depend on the company, discretion of the company. Because para sa amo, 10 pesos is material. But for some companies, 10 pesos is not material. So this is based on judgment. Diba? This is based on judgment. So if you think that the amount is not material, then you can offset the overdraft. Or let's say, in this case, para sa ako, company, kanang 30,000 nga negative, immaterial na para sa ako. Immaterial na para sa ako. Question, pilay balance sa akong cash? Para sa ako, immaterial ng 30,000 nga negative, pilay balance sa pilay balance sa akong cash. Let's have another illustration. Okay, kani siya, mamagini one. What if in ani nay tabo? Gidelete na ako ha. Okay, what if in ani ang nay tabo? Delete sa ikaduha. Okay, so, naka'y BDO, 50, 50, naka'y Metro Bank, 30, naka'y BPI, negative 10. Okay, para sa ako, kanang 10,000, para sa kumpanya, di ba, kanang 10,000 nga negative, na overdraft, immaterial na sa ila. Immaterial na sa ila. Question karon, kaninga case. Pila ang balance sa akong cash?
80, sir.
Para sa ako, immaterial ng 10K. Pilay balance sa akong cash?
80, sir.
Ha? Since immaterial para sa ako ang 10k, i-offset dili. Question, i-offset dili. Since not material, immaterial sa ako, immaterial sa ako ang 10k, i-offset dili.
Dili sir.
Unsa gani ni?
I-offset.
Exception
offset
to the rule on overdraft.
I-offset sir.
Okay, the first rule kani siya, di ba? Nakita na nato kung nakay duha ka bank account sa isa ka bangko, pwede ni mo i-offset. The second exception is if ang amount is not material. Material ni dili para sa ako.
Dili.
Therefore, dili sa material.
Therefore, i-offset.
I-offset ba?
Therefore, i-offset. I-offset, yes. Sir.
I-offset siya. I-offset siya kay dili sa material. Therefore, ang question ako, pilay balance.
70,000, sir. 70,000.
70,000,
sir.
70,000. Okay. I-offset na ako siya. Pwede na ako sa ma-offset. Biskan, lahi-lahi nga bank accounts. Diba? Okay. Lahi-lahi nga bank accounts. Because para sa ako, the 10,000 is immaterial, not material. Pwede na ako sa i-offset. But if the case para sa ako ang 10,000 material, dili sa i-offset. So kung dili sa, if material sa para sa ako ang 10K, the answer is 80K. Because kani siya, liability ni siya if material. Okay, so I hope it's clear ha. I hope it's clear ang kanang ikaduha. Okay. Okay, I hope it's clear ang ikaduha. So the third exception, kinataane, kitaane. Third exception is, according to IFRS, bank overdraft, pwede daw sa ma-offset against other bank account when payable on demand and as integral part of cash management. So, inyong timan, Andre, sa problem, kung naigatag nga problem sa inyo, if nakabutang nga ang bank overdraft is payable on demand and part of integral part of the company's cash management, then you can offset the overdraft to other bank accounts nga nag-positive. So, let's say for example, na kay BDO, 1 million, o, dinagko na ni Metro Bank, 500,000, na kay BPI, na 100,000, tapos na kay UCPB, nga negative 50,000. Okay. If sa company, lahi-lahi nga bank accounts, tapos na isa ka negative. If para sa company, kanang negative na 50,000, that's payable on demand or it's part of the company's integral part sa cash management sa company. Normally, sa problem, gina-state na ang mga wordings. Okay. So, pwede na ako sa i-offset. Diba? If payable on demand or integral sa as part of our cash management. So, question right now, pila ang balance sa akong cash if payable on demand siya at the same time part
1,550,000.
Okay, so that is 1 million plus 500 plus 5 plus 100, that's 1,600,000 minus 50.
Minus 50,000. That's 1,550,000.
Okay. So, muna siya. Ha? So, these are the exceptions. Diba? These are the exceptions to the general rule that bank overdraft is a liability and cannot be offset. So, that's the general rule, but we have exceptions. So, first is, if naakay duha ka account sa isa ka bank account, sa duha ka account sa isa ka bank. Second, if dili material ang amount sa overdraft. Third, if it's payable on demand ang overdraft. And integral part of cash management. So that is the exception to the overdraft rule. Let's go with compensating balance. Sir, unsa compensating balance? So, mura sa maintaining balance. So generally, takes the form of minimum checking balance or demand deposit account balance that must be maintained in connection with a borrowing arrangement with a bank. So, you say compensating balance, it's a minimum balance or maintaining balance nimo nga ipabili nimo sa imong checking account or demand deposit account, di ba, in connection with borrowing arrangement with a bank. Let's say, for example, kita ni, bank, pautanga ko og 1 million. Pautanga ko 1 million bank. Okay, oh, kita ni si company, si company X, si bank ni. Kita ni ha, bank pautanga ko og 1 million bank. Okay, si bank pod sige, pero sabot ta naay compensating balance ana. Oh, so let's say 10% compensating balance. So pila 10% sa 1 million, that's 100,000. Akong ihatag sa imo, since namantay compensating balance nga 10%, 900 ra akong ihatag sa imo. Ingon si bank, oh, sige bank, 900, kanang 10%, 100,000, magpabilin na rin sa imong account kang bank. Kaya mo na ang minimum balance, compensating balance, nga in case, maglisod kag bayad company X, dili na ko kaon imong pangbayad. Mura sa advance collection ni bank. Diba? Mura sa security purposes ni bank. So, ang 100,000, that's compensating balance. So, that is the minimum amount na ipabilin nimo sa imong account in connection with borrowing arrangement with the bank. So, siyempre si bank, at the same time, it's a security on the part of the bank na nigurado si bank na sa 1 million niya ako ipautang sa imo, 900 ra akong i-release sa imo. Ipabilin nako ning 100,000. Yes, initial and partial compensation. Oh, that's the term. Initial and partial compensation of the borrowing. Diba? So, pwede siya. So, that is compensating balance. Question karon, sir, kanang 100,000, unsa na pag-record? Appeal ba na sa akong cash? Or dili na sa appeal sa akong cash? Because, sir, ka 900, appeal sa imong cash. Diba? So, question karon, kanang 100, appeal ba na sa imong cash?
Cash on bank.
Or, appeal ba na sa imong, or dili ba na sa appeal sa imong cash? Question is, depende. The answer is, it will depend. Okay. Classification of compensating balance. Okay, depende siya. So, the compensating balance, pwede siya part sa imong cash. Kanus, when? Kanusa siya? Kanusa sa ma-part sa imong cash? When the compensating balance is unrestricted. So again, compensating balance is part of your cash when it is unrestricted or naara mo'y informal arrangement or agreement. Okay, if you only have informal agreement or if the compensating balance is unrestricted, then that's the time that the compensating balance, the 100,000, pwede sa nimo i-appeal sa imong cash. Sir, what if naka-restricted? Depende kung short term ra pud siya. Kung short term siya, that's part of your cash, unrestricted short term siya. Tama na siya. Okay, so next is, sir, what if naka-restricted siya? Kano sa matama kaingon nga restricted ang compensating balance when there is a formal agreement? When there is a formal agreement. Okay, so kung formal agreement, pasabot na naka-restricted ang imong compensating balance. Question, unsa na to pag-report ang 100,000? Automatic, dili sa part sa imong cash. But pwede siya sa imong asset gyapon siya. Pero dili sa cash. Let's say other asset or let's say long-term investment. O sige, let's say other asset latong gamiton. So other asset siya. The question karon is current ba or non-current? So, depende sa imong agreement, loan. Depende sa imong loan agreement. What if long-term nga loan agreement, then this is non-current asset. Pero if short-term lang agreement, that is current asset. Cash held as compensating balance equals short-term. Yeah, automatic, that's short-term. Once it is unrestricted. Okay, automatic gina siya, unrestricted part of your cash na siya. Okay, so again, to report the compensating balance, pwede ra siya ibutang sa pag-entry, sir. Pwede ra sa short term. Pwede ra, short-term asset or other asset. Pwede po, short-term asset. Pwede ra. As long as ma-identify siya nga current asset siya. Pwede ra butan ninyo yung short-term asset ang inyong pag-account sa iya. Pwede ra siya. Okay, so that is compensating balance. Okay, that is compensating balance. Question so far. Question so far?
None, sir.
Okay, wala. Let's continue. Unsa ning undelivered unreleased check or unreleased check? Okay, because sometimes, di ba, nag-prepare taog FS at the end of the reporting period, let's say, mag-prepare taog FS December 31, 20, karon, ting prepare na karon, di ba, okay, after year end. Undelivered or unreleased check, literal, wala pa na-deliver, wala pa na-release nga check eh. Okay, di ba, so unsa na itabuan eh, kita, si company A. Okay. Natay gibayaran. Diba? Gibayaran nato ang atong supplier. Cheque atong gibayad. So, nag-issue taog cheque. Let's say, December 2020. Padulong kang supplier. Di-issue nato ang cheque ani nga date. Diba? Pero ang cheque wala pa nahatag kang supplier. Nagsulat lang ka, 'di ba? Nagsulat lang ka pay to supplier A on ang date sa cheque, issue date sa cheque mo ni gibutan nimo December 2020. Pero ang cheque unreleased, undelivered, wala pa napasa kang supplier. Nilapas nag December 31. Nilapas nag December 31, wala pa gyapon ni abot. Wala pa na release. Wala pa na deliver or wala na deliver or wala na deliver man gani kang customer, na deliver man gani kang customer A, pero wala pa niya gipa in cash. Ay na deliver man gani kang supplier, pero wala pa gipa in cash ni supplier sa bangko. Question karon, kanon sa nato gi-issue? December 20. Di ba, upon issuance, on sa itong entry, nagbayad man ta, so accounts payable, cash. Cash in, let's say, hindi, wala na lang amount. Di ba, on December 20, because kaniman nga time atong gi-issue ang cheque, nagsulat ta, gibutan na itong date, bayad ni kang supplier A. Pero ang cheque, wala nahatag kang supplier A, nilapas na lang December 31, wala pa nahatag sa iya, or nahatag naman gani sa iya, pero pag abot, nilapas sa December 31, wala pa gihapon niya, gipa in cash. Question karon, if kani ang case, on December 31, kisa pa itag iya sa cash, nga wala pa na-deliver kang supplier. Dili na lang ta sa undelivered. Diba? Nag-issue ta, kita ni, si company, bayaran na to si supplier. December 20, nakabutang, issued na ang check, nanay date ang check eh. So, pag-issue na to, nag-entry ta na, accounts payable, kaya nagbayad man ta, nag-issue ta, accounts payable cash. Tapos, wala na deliver ang check eh. Niabot na lang December 31. Question karon, kisa pa'y na ay control sa cash? Si, let's say, entity or si supplier? Okay. The entity. So, unsay buhato nato? Kisa'y mo record sa cash on December 31, di ba dapat kita pa ang tag-iya sa cash? Si E pa ang tag-iya sa cash. So, unsay buhaton niya, pero nag-credit na sa cash dire. So, unsay mong buhaton, ibalik nato. Diba, ibalik nato ang cash. So, ang may tabuan ni, ato nisang i-reverse ang entry. Diba, i-reverse nato ni, ibalik nato ang cash, debit, ibalik na to itong utang kaya wala pa maging nabayaran. Diba? Nag-gets siya? Ha? Nag-gets siya? Oh, diba? So
yes,
kita pag-apoy tag-iya sa cash because, diba, on December 31, manguta naman na, pilay balance sa imong cash. Oh, adjusting entry. That's the adjusting entry. I-reverse ra nato siya. G-reverse ra nato. G-reverse nato itong g-entry because kita pa tag-iya sa cash. So, gibalik nato ang cash, gibalik po nato ang liability. So, therefore, kung nai undelivered or unreleased check, that's part of your cash. That's added on your cash.
Required siya, sir.
Yes. Mogi na siya. Dapat, ibalik yun mo siya. Pero, di ba, na statement sa libro na normally, mga companies, dili na kayo nila gina-adjust. Because, siguro, kung sa kadaggan sa transactions, i-monitor pa nila kung kinsa ang wala pa na-deliver ng mga check. Eh. Pero if there is undelivered check, it should be added back ang cash. So added back ang cash by preparing this entry, adjusting entry. Cash, debit cash, credit, accounts payable. Okay, na question dire. Sa adjusting na i-reverser. Yes, kumbaga, adjusting entry ni, pero ang imong gibuhat, gibalik, gireverse ra ni mo ni nga entry, di ba? So it's an adjusting entry, but imo ra siyang gireverse ang entry ni mo. Okay. Dili sa reversing entry ha, dili sa reversing entry. It's an adjusting entry, pero ang imong adjusting entry, gireverse ra nimo ni. Kana lang siya, dili sa reversing entry. Asa ibalik sir sa entity? Kumbaga kita sa entity, imo namang gi-credit pasabot wala na sa imo ang cash, pero kinsa pertag iya on December 31, kita gihapon entity. So mo nang ibalik nimo ang cash, mo nang nag-debit kag cash. Ibalik po ni mga utang, siyempre. Okay, that's undelivered or unreleased check. Napapunta yung itawag nga post-dated check delivered. Kagaina, kani, wala na, na issue, pero wala na deliver. If ever, sir, ang unreleased check is issued sa July and adjusting entry bagyapon ana sir is on December. Depende na sa reporting sa company. Let's say, pero normally pag cash transactions every month, dapat mo compute yung pilay balance sa imong cash. So kung July siya, mag-adjusting entry ka on July 31. Yan na siya. So okay, normally every month ang counting sa cash, pilay balance sa cash. Pero kung ang company dili kayo stricto, whole year sila, then mo pwede December na ka mag. Pero layo na pud kaayo ng July, 'di ba? Let's say July tapos 6 months aro dili pa ma-deliver, 'di ba? Kamo mag-monitor pud ang company sa mga bayro noon. So ma-cancel ang check, sir. Dili ma-cancel ang check. Dili ma-cancel ang check. Dili ma-cancel ang check. Naragya po ng check, kaya wala lang na-deliver pa. Diba? I-deliveray pa. Mauna imong i-reconcile, sir. Apil ang undelivered checks, ana. I-reconcile. Ano siya pasabot ni mo sa reconcile? Dito na ni sa bank reconciliation na part. Sige, maabot na dira kanang reconcile ha, maabot na dira kanang reconcile. Okay, sige, so let's proceed with, again, undelivered check, issued, but not yet delivered. Issued, but not yet delivered. Natay isa ka check pag gitawag, post-dated check delivered. Kanina, na-deliver na, kita ni, na-deliver na, December 31 ang check eh, pero naka-post-dated. Diba? Kita ni entity, supplier, na-deliver na nato. Okay, na-deliver na nato. Ang check ay na-deliver na. Pwede po baliktad. Okay. Pero naka-post-date siya. Diba? Issued, delivered, but naka-post-date. Sir, on say post-date, sir? Diba? Post-after. Let's say, for example, karon ni mo gibuhat ang cheque o money ang cheque. Pay to A. 1 million. Pero ang date niya dire karon nimo gibuhat, let's say December 29, karon nimo gisulatan ni, pero ang naka-date dire let's say January 3. That's post-dated. Giiso nimo karon, giiso nimo ang cheque, pero ang date sa cheque naka-advance. Dili same date on the day nga imong giiso. That's post-dated. Naka-post date siya, naka-advance ang date sa cheque. Sir, unsaon man na? Unsaon man ang post-dated check? Okay, depende. Depende kung payable to or gikan kang customer. Kita ni. Sa para dili siya. Okay, post-dated check delivered. So, kita ni. Pwede man gini ang post-dated from customer. Or payable to supplier. Duha ni sa ka-post-dated. Let's say, kita ni. Kita si entity. Money si supplier. Money si customer, di ba? So, palitag supplies kang supplier, tapos ginabaligan ito kang customer. So, ang itabuan ni, post-dated check, pwede siya nga, kita, entity, nagbayad ta kang supplier, naka-post-date siya. Pwede po da si customer, nagbayad sa ato, naka-post-date po ang check eh. Okay, so because sa problem, kinahanglan nyo identify kinsa ta, kakinsa gikan ang post-dated nga check. Kita ba nagbayad ana kang supplier or gikan ba na gibayad sa ato ni customer? Because lahi ang treatment. Okay, nani ang treatment? Diba? Kita ni. What if nag-issue ta og check eh, kang supplier, gibutan na to post-dated. Diba? Post-dated. Giiso na to ang cheque on December 29. Pero ang date sa cheque naka January 5. Sir, unsa day effect anang post-dated? Kanang post-dated, kung unsay date nakabutang dito sa cheque, kana pod nga date nga pwede i-incash ang cheque, pwede i-deposit ang cheque. Mo nang purpose sa post-dated. Diba? So, like kung karon nag-iso kong post-dated nga cheque, tapos ang date sa cheque kay next week, dili na pwede gamiton ang cheque karon. Pwede ra na siya ma-incash katong date nga nakabutang sa check. That's why post-dated siya. Normally, mo na ang ginabuhat sa kanang installment, magbayad og installment. Diba? So, siguro kung ang uban nga na-experience, ang uban na, wala pa kanang na-experience, post-dated, like, ang date sa post-dated, good for 12 months. So, ang date, karon ni mo giiso ang check eh, pero ang date kay January 1, 2020, February 1, 2020, March 1. So, naka-post-date na ang check eh. Okay, so, unsay effect ana niya? Siyempre, upon issuance na to, kita, unsa tong entry pag issue na to on December 29. So, nag-record ta, nagbayad ta sa supplier ha, nagbayad ta. So, that's accounts payable, cash. Pero ang cheque, pwede ra ma-incash kanus-a on January 5. Okay. So ang cheque nilapas na, ang cheque pwede ra sa ma-incash on January 5 because naka-post date siya. Question karon, on December 31, 2020, kisa pay tag-iya sa cash, kisa pay nay control sa cash.
Ang entity, sir.
Ang entity. Nga naman, karong sa araw pwede ma-incash si supplier January 5 pa. Therefore, dili pa na mabawasan ang atong cash because January 5 pa, pwede i-incash ni supplier ang cheque. Okay, so unsay may tabuan na, nag-entry naman taan ni, unsa itong buhaton. So, ibalik na po dato. Diba? So, mag-prepare na po tag-adjusting entry. Unsa itong adjusting entry on December 31. So, ibalik na to ang cash na po. So, cash, accounts payable. Pag abot og January 5, balik na po dato accounts payable, in-cash. Kay di ba, pwede na niya ma-in-cash on January 5. Pero ang question karon on December 31, kinsay tag-iya pa sa cash. Kita pa, that's why ibalik na to. Okay. O, direta sa PCAS, what if si customer nagbayad sa tuog post-dated? Di ba? Kita ang nidawat. So, si customer iyang gi-issue December 29. Iyang gihatag sa to December 29, pero ang date sa cheque naka January 5. Di ba? Naka January 5. So, ang pagdawat na to sa cheque, normally, ang atong entry ana, nakadawat tag cash, accounts receivable, gikan kang customer, di ba? On December 3, 29. Question. On December 31, naabagi cash nga atong nakuha?
Wala, sir.
Wala pa, sir. Man? January 5 pa man
ato. January 5 pa mag-effect.
Pagamit, di ba? Pero nag-entry na taan eh. Or let's say, wala pa ta nag-entry kay wala pa man ato na, di pa man ato pwede ma-in-cash. So, question karon kasi tag-iya sa cash pa.
Entity.
Ang entity ang tag-iya sa cash? Kita ang entity.
Customer.
Customer. So, dili sa part sa atong cash. So, kung tanawin ninyo ang transaction na, that's why you need to identify unsa nga post-dated check. Gibayad ba nato kang supplier or gidawat nato kang customer? Because kung gibayad na to kang supplier naka-post date, part sa atong cash. Pero kung gibayad di customer sa ato post dated, dili sa part sa atong cash. That's why you need to identify unsa nga post dated check. From customer ba, customer post dated check ba na, or post dated check payable to supplier? Diba? Kita ba ang nag-issue or kita ang nakadawat? Because lahi ang treatment ana. Because kung kita ang nag-issue sa post-dated, that's part ibalik sa atong cash. Pero kung kita nakadawat og post-dated from customers, wala sa ilabot sa atong cash. Di sa included sa atong cash. Okay. So kung inani ang case, let's say, pag-entry, so pag-adjusting entry na ito, i-reverse na po na, pwede na po na ito ni siya i-reverse. So I hope it's clear, ha? Clear siya?
Yeah.
Okay, sige, let's proceed. Stale check or long outstanding. Kung si stale check, sir, what if nilapas ka sa date nga dapat nimo sa i-incash? Walay problema kung mulapas sa date. Let's say, for example, money ang check, eh. Oh, karon ni gi-issue, tapos nakabutang diri kay Feb 2. Di Feb 3 naman ta karon, di ba? Oh. Hantod karon napasako ning cheque, pero February 2 nakabutang, walay problema pag inana because anytime pwede nimo ma-incash ang cheque basta starting Feb 2 onwards. But if dugay kaayo nimo i-incash, mo ni mahitabo. Mas stale or ma-check long standing. Sir, on say stale. Kumbaga murag mawala ang dili na nimo ni sa pwede magamit nga cheque. 'Di ba? Mas stale na siya. Kumbaga murag useless. 'Di ba? Di nimo sa magamit nga cheque kay kung mulapas kanya dugay na kayo after 6 months, normally stale check is considered stale pag dili pa siya ma-incash within 6 months. Pero that's based, pero depende sa company policy. Like for example, kung 3 months wala pa gyapon gi-incash ni supplier, is stale na namo na. We'll advise the bank nga dili na ni pwede i-incash nga cheque. Okay, so walay problema mulapas, you could still incash the cash. 'Di ba? Ma-incash gapon nimo, pero kung pila na ka months ang nilabay tapos ang katong nag-issue sa cheque ilang policy kay 3 months lang na wala pa nimo na incash within 3 months, stale na ang cheque ana. So ang mahitabo ana, mangayon na po kag bag-o nga cheque, mag-issue na po na sila bag-o nga cheque para sa imo. Mabalik sa entity na, sir, if wala na incash. Naaraw man na sa entity because wala man na nabawas, 'di ba? Kay let's say na 1 million sa imong bank, nag-issue ka ani, kung wala na in-cash, magpabili na nga 1 million, dili ingon mabalik. Tibos wala man nabawasan. So, mag-depend lang yun na sa nag-issue. Yes, depende sa policy sa issuer. Like, kung 3 months lang ila, 6 months stale na, 3 months stale na, 1 month stale na, depende na sa ila. Okay, that's stale check, outstanding check, long outstanding checks. Oh, cash short or cash overage? Okay, say cash short or cash overage. So, di ba? So, kanusa ka makaingon nga na I short, na I over. Okay, di ba makamantay mo mga teller sa bangko? Means lang, na short ko. Di ba? Na short daw sila. So, kanusa ka makaingon nga na I shortage? When the actual cash count is lower compared to the records. Oh, nako sa bangko. Nag-ihap na ko kwarta. Ala, na record sa among system kay 100,000 ang akong na-collect. Pag-ihap niya sa cash, actual cash count, 99,000 ra. Mayroon sa halad na short ko. Pila yung short niya, 1,000. 1,000. Oh, 1,000, di ba? Mao niya nasa records, pero mao niya ang actual na ihap. Question, aha atong i-follow ang nasa record or ang actual? Ang actual. Ang actual atong i-follow. Ang 99. So, di ba ang sa atong record, naatay cash nga 100,000. Pero pag ihap na ito, 99 ra. That's why, unsa atong buhaton, we prepare adjusting entries. Nga dapat, mubangga siya sa 99. And that's why, atong entry, 100 man sa atong record, minusan nato nga mabot sa 99. So, mag-credit ta o cash, 1,000, we debit cash, shortage, or overage nga account. 1,000. So, this is only temporary account. Ha? Temporary account lang ni siya. So, ang question karon, kasi liable anang short nga 1,000? Normally, si Taylor good mo bayad ana. Normally, si Taylor good ang mo bayad ana. So, that's why, pag kang Taylor, umutan na to, receivable from Taylor, then ato nang i-close ang cash, short, or overage. 1,000. Oh, ana lang siya. That's the concept of shortage overage. Kung overage pod, baliktad ang naitabo, di ba sa kung overage pod siya, actual count is greater than records. Oh, ako teller. Hala sa akong record kay 100,000. Pero pag ihap na ako, ay hayahay na 105,000. Ala, over ko, sobra ko. Pwede due from teller, pwede ra. Due from teller, receivable from teller, pwede ra. So, actual, greater than record. So, this, ang result ani, na over. Kasi gani atong sundon, ang actual. So, therefore, atong entry, 100 ra itong na-record sa libro, pero ang actual 105, dungagan na ito og 5. So, debit tag cash, 5K, then cash, short or over dayon, 5K. Mm. So, kana lang siya. Pero kung ako ang teller, 100 ra ako ibutang dire. Pero joke ra ha, joke ra na. So, pwede man na nila kanang 5,000, pwede nila na ibutang like murag ban bitaw nga in case kung magka-short sila puhon, pwede rin nila kauon dira. Kana siya. Impress system. What mean by impress system? Kung may kag-impress system, all collections should be deposited. So, tanan collections sa business dapat ma-deposit and all disbursements is through checks. Unang impress system. Yung say impress system, tanan collection dapat ma-deposit, tapos tanan disbursement dapat isuan og cheque. That is the very good practice, di ba? Mo gid ideal practice, di ba? Para na ay controls. Because kung tanan na deposit, dali na kayo matrace. Tanan collections, yes, na deposit. Tapos, tanan disbursement, moagi og cheque, kay hasol kay ng cash ang imong ibayad. dili check kay basin pa lang ang cash, diba? Ibis 100 ang gipabayad, 50 ra gibayad kay naka-cash. Nakanindot sa check kay pwede man pangalan sa supplier imong ibutang, biskan kinsay nagunit ana, dili na nila ma-incash kay dili man sila ang pangalan nakabutang dito. Oh, that's the very good control. That's why impress system mo na sa ideal dapat limiton sa mga companies. Still decision sa entity sir obligation ang kana nga system. No. Kuan lang siya, mo ni ideal, but again, dili man makabuot, di ba? Kuon say practice sa company. So depende ra gyapon sa company, but this is a very good system, control system as a cash management nato. Okay, but sometimes impractical ra pod kaayo magpalit pagpalit og toyo kay kinahanglan kay naay pakaon sa office. Isuhan pag checke ang pagpalit og toyo, di ba? Kung impress system siya. So impractical ra pod usahay nga tanan disbursement iagi gid og checke. Diba? Like, papalit og snack digto, palit og snack kay naay mga bisita. Check ang ibayad sa tindahan, sa store, diba? So, naay mga times nga impractical siya. That's why, we set aside cash fund. We set aside petty cash fund. Diba, petty cash fund, those are small expenses. Kung mga ginagmay lang, diri na sa ginakuha. Okay, small expenses. Dili na sa ginakuha, petty cash fund. So, murag, let's say, depende po ng amount na ha, petty cash fund, depende na sa company. Like, for example, para sa amo, 5,000, mo na ang petty cash fund. So, mura na ang pwede magamit for small expenses. Napuntay limit sa small expenses. Let's say, for example, ingon ng company, 500. Pag 500 and below ang cost sa paliton, pwede ra ni mo kaon sa petty cash fund. Oh, dito ni mo kaon, pero pag mulapas sa gayon ng 500, check-in na good na siya, iso na nag-check-in. Depende rin po na sa company. So, the purpose of petty cash fund, again, small expenses lang. Purpose of small expenses. Kay impractical kung mag-iso ka og check-in. Diba? Sayang po, mas mahal pa ang check-in kaysa sa imong gipalit. Diba? So, that's why company establish petty cash fund. Manang purpose sa petty cash fund for small expenses. When you say petty cash fund, natay 2 ka system nga gina-apply. You have impress. Okay, fund system. And fluctuating. So actually, ang difference rani nila is on the replenishment of the cash. Okay, or ang entries niya, like siya. But depende sa company on sila gamiton impress ba or fluctuating. But ideal gyapon ang impress fund system for petty cash fund. So kumbaga mag-replenish lang ka pag pila to nagasto nimo. Kaya lang. So pwede niyo i-check ang entries sa libro, 'di ba? What's the difference between petty cash fund and impress fund system and fluctuating. Okay, so questions. Question. We are done. Actually, we are done with chapter 1. We are done with chapter 1. Sir, wala. How about the others? Nasabtan ra ba? Or sir, medyo wala ko sabot ato nga part. Sige.
None so far, sir.
How about ang uban? None. How about the others? Sure, ha? Wala? 1, 2, 3, 4.
None, sir.
Mga napulo anay ngan og nan about the 70. Oh, mga 15 na. 15 na ning og nan so far, di ba? Bantayan lan gud ha. Sige, mag-quiz ta karon, bantay lagi nang nan. Nan at the moment, sir. So, di ba? If nan, di ba? Ang amount sa i-replenish nila, sir, same lang sa Empress Fund. Actually, there's a difference. So actually, there's a difference under Empress Fund System and Fluctuating System. Because under Empress Fund System, ang i-replenish lang niya, katulang nagamit. Ah, let's say for example, ah, nakay 10,000 petty cash fund. Sa 10,000, na ay mga petty cash vouchers. When you say petty cash vouchers, money mga supporting documents, money mga source documents sa katunggi pang gastuhan. Ah, let's say petty cash vouchers nga worth 8,000. Kanang 8,000, sagol-sagol na dira. Nay toyo, kalaman, unsa pa nagipang palit dira. So, sampulan ng toyo, ha? So, sige pang palit, ana. So, sa 10,000, napay nabilin, nga 2,000. Sa Empress, ang i-replenish lang niya, kanilang 8,000. Because, napamay 2,000 nabilin. So, balay, iyang goal is, dapat 10,000 na gid ang balance sa petty cash fund. Okay, so, iyang goal, pag replenish niya, butang niya, unsa to nga mga expenses, tapos cash in bank, gibalik niya, pilay amount ato 8,000. That's for Empress. How about sa fluctuating, sir? Ang sa fluctuating pod, kay every time nga maggamit, maggasto, mag-entry gin sa diretso, like expense, petty cash fund iyang gamiton. So, murag real time siya, mag-entry gin siya. Okay, tapos pag replenish niya, let's say 10,000. Biskang wala pa na hurot, mo-replenish na po siya 10,000. Diba? Biskang wala pa na hurot ang petty cash fund nga 10,000, mo-replenish na po siya og 10,000. So, bisuman na yung kalahian nila. But, depende na lang sa company on sa ilang gamiton. Okay, pwede combined. Ako, usahay ako combined sa actual experience na ako, combined siya, usahay akong ginagamit. Okay, para tracing of transactions. Okay, other questions? Wala? Wala? Wala yung pangutan na?
None, sir.
Okay na to ha. Sige, Krista. Okay, low ba? Okay, sige. Wala, may pangutan na ka ha? Oh, answer this one. Okay, you can, I give you time to answer, then chat your answers. Tapos manawag ko to explain their answers. Or if na gusto mo volunteer, then you can volunteer. Ah, sige, for this first problem, sige, sabay sa tatanan. Sabay ta. Okay, question is, what is the correct balance of cash on December? Question, cash on December 31, 2020, and correct balance of cash on December 31, 2020, assuming the bank overdraft is repayable on demand and it's integral to the entity's cash management. So, kaninga problem, identify nato per item if cash ba siya, unsi classification niya. Let's start with, kanisa ta ha, number one sa ta focus. Okay, so L Company shows the following account balances and their financial records as of December 31. So, inani ang mga problems sa cash. First item, you have cash account at BDO. Unsa tawag ani? 20,000. Unsa ni siyan 20,000? Unsa tawag anang 20,000 ni BDO?
Overdraft?
Okay, that is overdraft. Okay, that is overdraft. Then you have part ba ni sa imong cash? Dili.
Dili, sir.
Dili, di ba? Unsa dai ni siya?
Dili, sir.
Liability, sir.
Liability.
Okay, this is a current liability account. General rule, di ba? General rule liability account. Second item, checking account at RCBC. Cash, dili?
Cash, sir.
Cash.
Diba? This is cash. Okay, cash, ni?
Cash, sir.
Cash.
Okay, payroll account, UCPB.
Cash.
Okay, payroll account, UCPB.
Cash, gihapon.
Ha? Okay, diba? This is a fund set
petty
aside.
Cash fund. Petty cash fund.
Kaning payroll account? No, this is not a petty cash fund. Payroll, di ba? Ang payroll tag 300 dinagko, di ba na? Okay, payroll. Yes, this is cash fund set aside for current purpose. Diba?
Current purpose.
3 months.
3 months? 3 months? Cash equivalent to 3 months, di ba?
Oh.
Dili is a cash. Okay, so this is cash. Yes, this is cash. Foreign bank account restricted.
Dili siya kuan cash.
Cash money part ni sa cash.
Dili.
Dili
sir.
Restricted
siya. Yes, sir. Kasi
restricted siya. Oh, nganong dili? Because nay restriction.
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 Diba? To yes, be sir. Part of the cash, dapat unrestricted.
Unrestricted yun yes.
So therefore, this is not part of your cash. Unsa classification ani? Baingon mo, dili cash, sir, pero unsa man na siya?
Long-term investment.
Investment. Non-current asset.
Non-current asset.
Unsa man na siya nga asset? Diba, this is considered as...
Long-term asset. Long-term.
This investment. Is considered as... Diba, foreign bank account.
Fuck. Puta. Lubat na ko.
Oy, pag-charge na dira.
Receivable.
Diba? It was discussed again na if restricted imong foreign na kay foreign bank account, if restricted siya, it is considered as receivable. Okay. Postage stamps. So din na, sir, postage stamps. Diba? Kanang normally ka ng mga stamps. Diba? So, unsa man siya? Postage stamps. Cash money?
Dili.
Cash money?
Dili.
Cash.
Dili.
Equivalent.
Considered as...
Ha? Dili no, sa cash. Diba? Pero unsa siya?
Expenses.
Cash equivalents.
Cash equivalents. Postage stamps ka na mga pampilit.
Expenses.
Expenses, sir.
This is considered
supplies.
As supplies. Supplies ninyo ni, di ba? Supplies. Ganito ninyo ni sa, kuan, pampilit na. Ikaw naman yung mga envelope, so pwede na siya. O, kani, customer's post-dated check.
Post-dated.
Dated?
Customer's post-dated check. Part sa cash, delay.
Delay.
Yes, I...
Oh, di ba? Post-dated sa sir. Pero karon pangutan na.
Receivable?
Pangutan na. Kita'y nag-issue, kita'y nagdawat.
Kita'y nag-issue.
Kita'y nagdawat.
Kita'y nagdawat. Kita'y nagdawat. Because gikan kang customer. Di ba? So part ba sa itong cash?
No. No.
Dili.
Receivable.
Dili.
Dili pa. Pwede ni siya considered as receivable ni mo.
Okay.
Okay. I owe you from President's brother. I owe you. Nay nag question dito sa nay nag question sir unsa nang I owe you?
Liability na sir.
Liability.
Literal na I owe you.
Pasabot anang I owe you, that's I.
Ah, I owe you.
I owe you.
Ah, owe you.
I
see. Liability.
Pero from
and out good na ako.
I owe you president's. From president's brother. Kumbaga, I owe you
from president's brother. Oh, account
receivable. Ang na si nay natay si I owe you. Brother, natay, oh, natay kolektahon noon. Sa president's brother.
Receivable.
Therefore, this is a receivable. Dili sa part sa cash, but this is receivable. So, man napasabot sa IOU ha? Literal nga, IOU. So, si president's brother na ay nahulam sa ato. So, nasa IOU. Traveler's check.
Cash.
Yes, this is cash. No sufficient funds check. Part ba na sa imong cash?
Cash sir, set aside.
Sir, unsa nang no sufficient funds check? Oy, nani may tabo ani. Si customer nagbayad sa tuog check eh. Pag adto na to sa bangko, gi-deposit na to sa oy bank, mag-deposit na mi bayad ni sa among customer. Pag ingon ni bank, oy wa man ni sulod. Mo na ingon talbog o mo na ingon talbog nga check eh. Bouncing check. So manang di ba kay ni talbog tungod kay walay sulod. So unsay na itabo? Nasulod ba to sa atong cash?
Wala.
Wala. Ngano man? Wala gani sulod. So wala na account sa ato. So dili sa cash. Pwede siya napagapuntay existing receivable kang customer because wala man to na account ang iyang bayad because wala isulod. Mm. So okay, next item.
Petty cash
fund. So sa imong petty cash fund, because impress system ang atong assumption na ginagamit, sa 100,000 ni mga petty cash fund, naanay nagamit na pila 84,000.
84.
Muna na itong 84. Na mga petty cash vouchers. So pila yung nabilin sa imong petty cash fund?
16,000.
16,000. So therefore, the 84 is expenses. The 16,000, mula na nai nabilin na cash ni mo. Diba? 16,000 petty cash fund. Okay. Cashier's check.
Cash.
Yes. This is part of your cash. Okay. Question number one. What is the correct balance of cash on December 31, 2020? So, kauna na to. So, cash gapon si 16K. Sir, yes. Petty cash fund. Diba? Atong cash is petty cash on hand. Cash in bank petty cash fund. So, let's cash na to, 500 plus 100 plus
16.
50. Napay traveler's check. Tingnan na to ha. Okay. Plus 16 plus 36. Pila na?
600.
That's 500 plus 100 plus 50 plus 16 plus 36.
652.
702.
That is 702,000. So the answer ani 702,000. Okay, that's 702,000. So di ba mato ang atong cash for number one. Number two, what is the correct balance of cash on December 31, 2020? Assuming the bank overdraft is repayable on demand and it's integral to the entity's cash management. So, di ba? Ang kanidang 20,000, repayable daw na on demand.
Question pwede daw, offset.
Pwede ba ma-offset, dili?
Pwede.
Pwede, di ba? This is the third exception. Di ba? Once repayable on demand siya and part of the entity's integral cash management, integral to the entity's cash management, then we could offset the 20,000 overdraft to other bank accounts. So, pwede nimo sa i-offset kang checking account kang RCBC. Therefore, pilay balance sa atong cash. That is 702,000 minus
20,000.
So, that is
682,000.
Okay, that is the correct answer. 682,000. Oh, simple ra, di ba? Sinala na ito mga problem. Okay, di ba? Identify lang ni mo kung cash ba na siya. Okay. Oh, second problem. Nabungkag. Sir, can we have illustration where adjusting entries are required? Adjusting and for this illustration, dili kayo necessary adjusting entries ani because per item raman yun na siya. Murag, wala yung exact transaction na itabo. Items lang, accounts lang ang ipanghatag. So, we need to identify. Classify lang na to. Cash, bani, unsa ni siya. Inana kasagari ang sa cash nga problem. But, later on, sa next nga chapter, dito na na yung kinahanglan adjusting entries. Sige lang, muabot na din sa adjusting entries. O, kani, medyo nabungkag ang format ani. Itong ikaw na plaster. So, this is 50,000 ni. Sige daw, answerin ninyo. Compute for the following. Compute first for the cash. Compute for the cash equivalents. And compute for cash and cash equivalents. Hindi na tumapas karon ang bank record. Next meeting na lang ta sa bank record. Sige, I'll give you time, di ba? Identify pila ang cash equivalents. Siyempre, if ma-compute ninyo ang first two questions, automatic. Sige. Sige, you can chat your answers, ha? Guess lang, di ba? So, at least you try. Okay lang katong mga kuan, katong mga nai klase pa. Sige, nai nag-answer number 1. Okay, it's okay, it's okay. Itong nai mga class katong mga third, mga second year. Pwede ra. Saka mag-solve po dai ko, be. Okay, nanay nag-answer dire.
Yes, sir.
Yes, this is part of our cash. Checks received from customers.
Yes, sir.
Check yes, sir.
Yes, diba? Di, nadawat na nato. Checking and nadawat kang customer. Therefore, cash na ang check, diba? Check is considered cash. So, this cash. Certificate of deposit. Term 12 months.
Wala pa, sir.
Diba, kung may kang certificate of deposit, that's time deposit. You say time deposit, that's cash equivalents. But take note, the term is 12 months. Pila na ganito para cash equivalents? 3 months.
3 months.
Therefore, dili siya cash equivalent. Long term, other asset siya. No, other asset siya. It's a short term investment gapon because 12 months. Within 1 year. So, let's say na lang other asset siya. Other assets siya. Petty cash fund. Part sa cash. Diba? Cash. Treasury bill. Kabalot nga. Ang treasury bill is a cash equivalent. Batanaw na ito. Kanos sa gi-purchase? 3 months ba before its maturity? Kanos sa gi-purchase? December 1. Kanos sa due? February
28.
3 months ba?
Balance 3 months.
Diba? December. Yes. December, January, February. So within 3 months sa gi-purchase. So therefore, unsa yung classification ani?
Cash in cash.
Cash. Cash equivalent. So this is cash.
Cash
equivalent.
That is cash equivalent.
Equivalent.
Okay, next, Bank A checking account balance. So nakay balance checking account kang Bank A 212 million, and that is cash. Post-dated check from customer.
Receivable cash.
Okay. Cash ba ni?
Dili, sir.
Receivable.
Dili sa cash. So, let's say this is receivable. Okay. Receivable.
Post-dated siya.
Okay. Because customer nga post-dated check. How about money order from customer?
Cash.
Cash, sir.
This is cash. Diba? Money order is part of your cash.
Cash on hand.
Okay, cash on hand, di ba? Cash in savings account. Kani, samot cash, di ba? Kaya naka-savings
cash
account.
In bank.
Okay, cash in bank. Cash lang yan po natong gamiton. Money market purchase December 1, 2020, due March 31, 2021. When you say money market, that's cash equivalent. But the question, is it within the 3 months period?
4 months na okay. siya.
December, January.
3 months ba?
Ay, sir.
Diba? December 1 to March 31. So, December, January, February, March, that's 4 months already. Therefore, cash equivalent ba siya?
No, sir.
Dili. Oh. So, other asset ni siya.
Other asset.
Other asset.
Okay, next. Bank draft from customer. Chan eh? Bank draft from customer.
Cash.
Cash?
Draft?
Cash? Cash, sir.
Bank draft?
Yes, sir. Belong man siya sa cash on hand.
Okay. Cash on hand ni siya. Basi matinga mo overdraft. Dili na overdraft. That's bank draft.
Ang tagani ng bank draft,
ang bank draft, dili kay kukuha na kung unsa ng bank draft, pero part siya sa cash on hand.
Okay.
Ato lang nang, pwede na ito, sir, ma-search na sa YouTube basi hindi ma-present na dito. So, utility deposit to gas company refundable. Sa Manisiya. Murag, deposit, di ba? Kung baga, kanong palit kag coke, wala kay butilya. So, na kay deposit 5. Kung sa wala ni mo ng 5 sa tindahan.
Receivable.
Naka-receivable sa tindahan, 5.
So, cash na siya, sir, di ba?
Receivable pa siya.
So, di pa siya considered na cash?
Di pa siya considered as cash because gibayad naman na nimo. So, naka-receivable. Refundable man siya, so that's receivable. Dili sa cash, ha? Dili sa cash. Cash advance received from customer.
Cash.
Kay nakadawat og cash, sir. Ang account na ha, ang account cash advance received from customer. Pasabot, murasag gibayaran ta daan, bisan wala pa ta nag render sa service. Unsa man siya, cash na siya?
Cash.
Liabilities.
That's a liability. Diba?
Wala na render nga service.
Wala pa naka, di ba napatay i-render nga service. Dili kay sir na may cash nga word so cash na siya. Ang account atong gitan-aw.
Okay.
Ay o katong gamit daan di sir bayad sir. O kana, di ba? O kana. Baliktad bayad daan before gamit. Diba? Baliktad.
Bayad before gamit.
Diba? Bayad una, di ba? O unearned income, tama. That's unearned income, that's a liability. That's a liability. Okay, NSF check, C company, cash money, dili. Di ba? Dili. Kay walay sulod ang gibayad sa ato ni customer. So, dili sa cash, pwede sa receivable. Napag-apunta yung dawat tunon kang customer. Bank B checking account overdraft. Sa money,
negative.
Ability, sir.
This is?
Negative.
Overdraft.
Ano sa man eh?
Overdraft.
Kasi classification, cash ba ni?
Daily.
Liability.
Liability.
Ano sa nga liability?
Liability. Current liability.
Okay, that is current liability. Diba, general rule? Wala. General rule, current liability sa dili sa i-offset. Sir, on sa NSF, no sufficient funds.
Ano hindi siya i-offset, sir?
Sir, auto, hindi siya offset.
Bank A, na may bank A siya.
Sige ito, general rule, dili siya i-offset. Kano sara sa ma-offset?
2 or more.
If dili siya material.
Dili siya material. Nabagingon nga dili material, wala takabalo. Diba?
Pero dili na siya pareha sa bank A, sir.
Ang first exception, nakay duha ka account sa isa ka bank. Kinsa man nga bank, bank B. Kinsa man nga bank, bank A. Okay, tog bank A, account 1. Tapos bank A, gihapon ni account 2. Pwede siya i-offset, di ba? So that's the first exception. Pero kani, lahi nga bank. Bank A ni, bank B ni siya. Muna yung bantayan. So therefore, this is current liability. General rule, shall not be offset to any other account balances. Okay, next item. IOUs from employees.
Receivable.
This is receivable.
Receivable.
Okay, certificate of deposit. Term 3 months.
Cash equivalent.
cash aid.
Equivalent.
Unsa gayud ang certificate of deposit? Equivalent to
time deposit.
Time deposit. Diba? Equivalent to time deposit. So therefore, 3 months man ang term. So this is cash equivalence. Postage stamps.
Supplies.
Cash set aside for expansion.
Cash.
Investment.
Cash set aside for expansion.
Investment.
Other
asset, sir.
Other asset.
This is other asset. Di sa pwede makas. Although cash siya, pero set aside. Set aside na ay restriction. Diba? Na ay restriction. Para on siya yung restriction for expansion. So, diba, once restricted, dili sa part sa cash. Therefore, let's consider this one as other asset. Time deposit, 3 months.
Cash equivalent.
Manata, di ba? So, let's identify pila ang cash na to. So, ang cash na to, 50,000 plus 600 plus 4,000 plus 2,100,000 plus 15,000 plus 100,000 tulinginan na
2,909,000
okay. Plus 15 plus 100
2,909,000
40 dapat ba? Wala na, di ba? Pila na?
2,909,000.
So that is the answer for number 1. The total balance for cash is 2,909,000. Oh, number 2, cash equivalent. So pila cash equivalents? Kani 50. Oh man, kani 41. Tapos 50,000. Na pa ba? Wala na, di ba? Cash equivalents, kani?
141,000.
Pila?
141,000.
That's cash equivalent. So, therefore, cash and cash equivalents, 2,909 plus 141,000. Pila na? That's 2,000,000 at that's 3,000,000.
3,050,000.
That's 3,050,000. I-total ra, di ba? Kay cash and cash equivalents man siya. So, that's 2,909,000 plus 141,000. So, that is 3,050,000. Oh, simple okay, ra, di ba?
Dili lagi.
Oh, naid lang yun siya i-identify. So.
Oh, identify lang yun. Kay kung masayop mo kita, sayop tanan.
Love the world.
Oh, kana siya. So, dapat bantayan ninyo. Okay. So, sige, last problem for this evening discussions. Napaday, sir. Sige, kani. Lahi po din approach. Oh, kani. Lahi na po din, di ba? So, dagan pwede question, ani. So, ang question, ani, pila ang cash balance?
Cash balance?
Cash balance. Cash and cash equivalents na lang. Pila ang cash and cash equivalents. Ah, sige, answer na tayo dito para mahuman na dayon ta. Kay murag apit na, the size na kapin na. No? So, gutom na. Okay, petty cash fund.
Punto, sir.
Sige lang, tiwaso na sa natin eh. Petty cash fund, cash equivalents.
Cash.
Cash in bank current account.
Cash.
Cash in bank payroll account.
Cash.
Di ba? Cash in bank sinking fund.
Cash. Wala pong
sige. Pending. Sinking fund. Murag sinking fund. Familiar mo na sa high school, sa elementary, di ba? Uy, sinking fund, piso-piso ka daan.
Sinking fund.
Okay.
For a certain purpose.
Cash.
Sige, pending. Pending. Kay nai-giyoyo sa ubos. Di ba, nai-giyoyo sa ubos. Sige, yan na. Palayan sa ta. Cash on hand. Kani, sure na, sir. Cash. Cash in bank, restricted account for plant expansion and expected
long term.
Other assets?
Other assets.
Other asset, long term niya, non-current asset.
Yes, sir.
Okay, plant addition man, so non-current asset man siya. Treasury bills.
Cash equivalent.
Silent ang
cash
problem.
Equivalent.
Silent ang problem, therefore, that is cash equivalent. Oh, nasa additional details dire ngun sa the petty cash fund daw kanida yung petty cash fund nga 50,000 included unreplenished December 2020 petty cash expenses vouchers of 5,000 and IOUs of 5,000. Kanada yung 50,000 na appeal daw dira ang unreplenished petty cash vouchers katong mga gasto expenses nga 5,000 og na IOU nga 5,000. Question,
pilay system sir.
Yeah, yes. So, sa 50,000 nibo, pila ang correct 10, balance na lang sa imong petty cash fund?
40,000.
Okay, di ba? Sa 50 minus 5,000 minus 5,000 because this is not cash account, this is receivable. Di ba? Receivable man ang IOU, di ba? So, dili sa appeal. So, minus 5,000, so pila ang balance sa imong petty cash? 40,000. Okay, next.
48,000.
Okay, so next nga problem, cash on hand daw, so kani si cash on hand, included a 100,000 customer check payable to Campbell dated January 15, 2020. Kasi tawag ani nga check?
Post-dated.
Post-dated.
Post-dated. Ngano man, 'di ba? January 15.
15 man.
Pero December 31 na-issue na siya.
Post-dated. Ano may kuan date daan?
Oh, 'di ba? Naka January 15 iyang date.
Advance.
Tapos December 31 pa ta karon. So therefore naka post-dated check siya. Question. Question, unsa nga post-dated check? Payable to supplier or received from customer?
Payable.
Payable
to customer. To customer.
Payable to customer, payable to supplier.
Payable from customer.
Supplier.
Ano man na, post-dated check, payable to to supplier, or post-dated check from customers. Diba? Receive from customers. So, unsa man yung post-dated?
Receive from customer. Receivable.
Receive from customer or payable to supplier?
Payable to supplier.
Anong payable man kay sir? Na may payable sir, payable to supplier.
Receivable.
Tanawa ka kinsa payable?
Kakinsa ang payable? Customer man ang mubayad.
Receivable from customer.
Di ka kinsa payable ang cheque? To
Campbell.
Kinsa tanga company?
Campbell.
Therefore, kinsa gikan ang customer? Kinsa gikan ang cheque?
Kang customer.
Kang customer. Oh, bantayan na ninyo.
Receivable.
Bantayan na ninyo ha kana ang wordings ana niya. Check payable siya pero kinsa payable? Kang Campbell, kita si Campbell. Therefore, gibayad di customer sa ato. So therefore, this is customer's post-dated check. PDC. Manang itawag PDC ha, post-dated check, PDC. Therefore, dili sa cash, di ba? Not part of your cash because this is still receivable. Pero na-appeal ba ni? Na-appeal ba ni sa 500,000?
Yes,
di ba? Included na-appeal sa 500,000 ang 100. Appeal ba dapat siya?
Dili.
Kung saan itong buhaton?
Minus.
So, minus 100,000. Bilin na bilin.
400,000.
So, pwede akong pangutanan ni sa inyo, pilay balance sa cash on hand? Answer, 400,000. Pilay balance sa cash in bank payroll account? Nanap, dakan pwede mo pangutanan eh. Sige, padayon ta. In exchange for a guaranteed line of credit, an entity has agreed to maintain a minimum balance of 20,000 in the unrestricted current bank account. So, tawag ani? In exchange daw nga para makautang ta,
Compensating balance?
This is compensating balance.
Compensating balance.
Diba? Morning compensating maintaining balance or maintaining balance.
Partial and partial.
Diba? So, exchange for guaranteed. Para nindot ang credit, dapat mag-maintain ta o balance nga in-ani. Diba? Question, compensating balance, unsa na to pag-record? Asa na appeal? Appeal siya kang current bank account. So, appeal sa diri. Na-appeal sa ani?
Yes, sir. Minus.
Question, compensating balance. Part ba sa cash or dili?
Dili na.
Dili.
So, sa ganito atong kinanglan timan-an pag compensating balance? Ala, kalimut na dahil yun.
Kailan ito, sir?
Kung dili siya legally restricted. Ah,
diba, ang compensating balance, pwede siya restricted, pwede siya unrestricted.
Depende.
Additionally,
diba, depende. Diba?
Anak magbuat sila formal na po.
So, unrestricted cash.
Okay, so compensating balance, cash. Unrestricted, part sa cash, dili?
Part
sa cash.
Part sa cash.
Yes. Unrestricted. Pero kung restricted siya, part ba sa cash?
No.
Dili sa part sa cash. Other assets siya. Question, kanang compensating balance ni mo, restricted, unrestricted?
Unrestricted.
Iba? Unrestricted. Therefore, appeal ba dapat sa iyo mong cash?
Yes.
Yes.
So, we're going...
So, unsay boto na to, ane?
Mag-add,
mag-minus, or wala tayo buhaton?
Wala. Wala yung change.
Wala, sir. Kaya appeal
wala yung changes.
Part naman siya.
This 200,000 is already included in the 4 million. Ang question karon, na-appeal na ba na siya sa 4 million? Yes, na-appeal, sir.
Yes.
Ang question karon, cash ba na siya?
Yes.
Yes, because unrestricted siya. Therefore, tama arangan na-appeal siya sa 4 million. So, wala tayo buhaton. Wala tayo buhaton, ha? Wala tayo buhaton. So, 4 million gihapon ng imong cash in bank current account. Kasabtan?
Yes.
Yes,
sir.
Ha?
Yes, sir.
Okay, sige.
Yes, sir.
Diba, nindot kayo ang cash. Diba, nindot kayo ni. Diba, challenging siya, diba?
Labi nagtinood.
Oh, diba, mapuro yung mong utok, ani. Sige, sunod na punta. Di, para itong basic accounting, debit, credit, maura. Diba, kanidere, dahan kay kagpangutan si mong kaugalingon. Next. Last item, the sinking fund is set aside to settle a bond payable that is due on June 30, 2021. So, di ba, depending na to kagaina ang sinking fund. Di ba? So, unsay classification, set aside daw siya to a bond
other asset
payable that is due on June 30, 2021.
Other asset, sir. Term.
Diba, unsay purpose sa sinking fund?
Murag short-term investment.
Short-term investment? Ganong short-term investment man? Kay short... Ganon man? O, diba? Kadundo mo gaya na itong parallel. The classification of the fund is parallel to the classification of the obligation. Question karon.
So, that is non-current.
Diba, the sinking fund is set aside to settle a bond payable that is due in June 30, 2021. Question karon, unsay classification sa bonds payable nato karon?
Liability.
It's a liability. As current or non-current?
Non-current. Ah. 4 months naman. Ay, 5. January, February.
The answer is
within one year.
Pero kay more than 3 months. So.
Short. More than 3 months, that is applicable for cash equivalent.
Cash equivalent naman na siya.
So, current,
within
current
1 year,
liability.
Current
liability.
Current liability.
The answer is still current liability. Because the definition of current liability within, to be settled within 12 months after the reporting period. Diba, the reporting period is December 31.
Yes.
Tapos, isettle siya June 31. So, within 12 months gapon siya after the reporting period. Therefore, this bonds payable is considered as current liability. Therefore, your sinking fund is also current asset, is also current and to be classified as part of your cash.
Liability.
cash siya. Because he set aside ni siya for current purpose, di ba? Current purpose, for a current liability. Di ba? Wow. Katulad kayo na cash fund for current operations or current liability equals cash and cash equivalents under current asset. So money purpose ani katong parallel. Okay, nasabtan ra ba? So big sir. Sige,
so i-deduct ba siya sa
so word problem na gid magdaog sir.
Oh, kana lagi. So tama ra nga 2 million
na
siya. That's part cash na siya ang 2 million. Because okay. Set aside siya nga fund for current purpose, for current liability.
Pero wala pa siya nabayaran.
Wala pa siya nabayaran. Napasay mo ang cash, di ba? So since ang iyang purpose is for paying the current liability, therefore the cash fund set aside is also considered as current asset as part of your cash and cash equivalents. Appeal siya. Pero kung if the silent is problem, walay gihatag nga supporting ani. Wala sa nag yaw-yaw aning sinking fund, balance payable. If silent, automatic cash. The sinking fund account is considered as other cash. Asset na.
Other asset.
Because kung yung sinking asset. Fund for long-term purpose setting siya. For long-term purpose siya. So
okay, sir.
Other asset Luka, siya.
Taga-adlaw.
Again, pag silent. Sample ra tong taga-adlaw ha. Bali mo ra tasog ka ng kono to kanang para mag-gets ninyo ang purpose of sinking fund.
Dili man
siguro na ang mga business, di ba? Oy, magbayad mo tag kuan, mag-save tag piso kada adlaw kay dinagko na gina ilang
gets. Just party na.
No, kanang mga inana, so mo na ang dire sa kaning cash in bank sinking fund. Gabi ibang ko pag ang kanang tag piso sa Christmas party, so mo na dinagko na gini nga amount dire. So, kana siya pag silent. Napugoy other wala na discuss sa inyo. So, pag compensating balance gani silent, wala gingon kung restricted or unrestricted. The assumption is unrestricted. Again, compensating balance if there's no if the problem is silent, the assumption is the compensating balance is unrestricted. Again, the assumption is unrestricted. So, if wala gibutang sa problem na compensating balance, unsa man ni? Wala gibutang restricted ba or not restricted. So imong assumption is unrestricted, therefore part of the cash. So maka-compute na ta, di ba? So maka-compute na ta, pila imong petty cash fund? 40,000 na lang. Di ba? 40,000 plus the 4 million.
4 million 40,000
plus the 1,200,000 plus the 2 million plus the
400,000.
Then plus the 1 million. Because ang question na ako, pila ang cash and cash equivalents?
Ah, okay.
So, pila man na? Oh, basi wak mo'y calculate tapad dira, ha? Nawa, good. 40 plus 4 million plus 1, 2. May pa ko na'y calculate. 2,000 plus 400 plus 1 million. Pila na? That's 8 million 640. Tama ba? Uwa po nag-type.
8,640,000.
So, 8,640,000. That is the answer. So, I hope no clear siya. Tapos, amoy nasabtan. Ma-apply good ninyo. So, di na nato maapas ang bank recon. Mas interesting ning bank recon. Diba? Mas interesting niya. Mas challenging niya siya. So, di naman maapas sa time. So next meeting na lang ta mag-discuss sa bank recon o proof of cash. So isaon na lang nato na siya. Okay, so questions, di ba? Before we end our class. Grabe sir, manilok man jud kagura sir.
Wala.
Wala sir.
Wala na. I hope ha nasabtan gyud, di ba? Nasabtan gyud siya. Hinaot pa unta, di ba? Ana siya. Sige. So if you have no questions, or you could also raise questions dito sa atong NIO basi na pang may gusto ipangutana. Sir, unsa tong ipasa sa? Sir, unsa tong sa NIO na ipasa? Basa ang NIO. Na day 8 p.m. Jo?
Na, sir.
Mao? Sige, check ra na ako. I-check ra na ako to. Sige, so napabay pangutana or wala na? So if you have no questions, I think let's call it a day. No, so thank you for katong wala pa na add sa niyo, i-comment lang mo dito sa akong post sa group kay para ako tong balikan karon para matan-aw na ma-double check na ako kung nanaba sa OPIS. So if you have no questions, no, thank you for coming for our class tonight, today. So I hope na naka-learn mo, diba?
Yes.
Magamit ninyo na sa atong quiz siguro within the week. So thank you again, class. So goodbye, goodbye.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir. Pop, sir, keep up.